Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning everyone. Morning. How are things going?
I'm great.
May Allah always protect us whenever and wherever we are.
Amen.
In this sunny morning, May Alfa Fauzia and my partner Ellen Lisi Maria are going to be the host on our show, Study Harmony on Humanity.
Yay. Study Harmony on Humanity is a program featuring the show of the coverage of songs that contain humanity elements.
As we know, currently there's been a war that hasn't stopped. At a moment like this, our human souls are put to the test whether we're going to stand down or help our brothers and sisters who are struggling. Therefore, we hope that all bad things are can quickly stop and replace with something far better, that is the peace. By the way, Ellen, what song are we going to figure out today?
Well, today we will figure out a heart-touching song that speaks about affection. The song is a pop song sung by an England young man, Haris J, and he is a singer of blends pop music with Islamic themes. In 2015, he had his debut album called Salam, and one of his songs is entitled I Promise, which is going to discuss today.
It's really exciting. Since he brings the music in Islamic theme in the country where the Islam is the minority. Okay, so here isn't just two of us who will join the show. We have a great guest who will discuss the song together. But before that, let's take a look at the performance of our friends, sung I Promise by Haris J.
Thank you.
Of course, they have to work hard. So without further ado, please welcome two of our best lecturers who will indeed bring new knowledge to all of us. Please welcome
Mr. Daddy
and Miss Nina. Today, Mr. Daddy and Ms.
I'm great today. I'm today. Friday is great for our days as a Muslim. Mm.
Yeah,
Jumu'ah Mubarak. Jumu'ah Mubarak.
Okay, so before we discuss the song, some are curious. Since when have you been interested in music and why? As we know, Mr. Daddy can play many instruments, and Ms. Luna really has nice voice.
Can sing many kinds of songs, from salawat until pop music.
And rocker, okay.
Could be lady rock in Faculty of Adab and Humanity. Have you ever heard about her pop rock?
No.
Why didn't you invite her to sing?
Just invite rock
and pop.
Maybe later we can sing together.
Yeah, of course.
Ellen, your question. So this is about music. Since we are in Faculty of Adab and Humanities, Adab includes literature, linguistic, and music. Mm-hmm. So we create this mood for our learning. Because in this state, you can see that you have to learn how to have good public speaking, and then how to welcome the guest star, and many things that you can learn in reality, not in the classroom. In the classroom, we cannot learn about this mood.
How we can good performance if we know more about music? How we can make more good, what is that? Good pronouncing.
That's amazing.
Because we have to make it clear if we want to listen some music and we can sing that song, how we can know more about articulation in our
mouth. Yeah, that's right. Like what you did, how to open our agenda. You have a good pronunciation, both of us. Probably how many weeks do you exercise yourself? How many days?
One day.
Okay, this is good. Just one day, you have that good pronunciation, and then you have to have a habitual action for
make confident in a camera.
Yeah, confident in camera. Smile in front of camera. Okay.
Amazing. Yeah. Uh-huh. So today we will discuss and bring a familiar song which the singer went viral at his time, especially 9 or 8 years ago. That is I Promise by Harris Day. Okay. We have some questions related to the song, and the first question is, maybe when we watch the music video of this song on YouTube or on other sites, we will see this image or symbol. So what do you think about this illustration that is being the symbol throughout this music video?
Okay, me first. This is the symbol, you know, this is funny and more meaningful because one man here, like cycle, okay, one man, and then inside one man, that is a woman. It is the mother and one child. Okay, Bumira, probably one child we have full of affection, full of love for one man here, and probably Harris J represents himself by this child, and this is, we have one a man here as a big one, as a father, and inside that we have mother, and probably it represents one child full of affection. That is one protection, Bumina, from father with mother inside and one child inside.
Big hug,
yeah. That's good. Yeah. Big hug means protection, love, and it must be like that. you are in the sixth semester, you will marry soon after graduation.
Yeah. And after that, you have a child.
Yeah. Oh, child. Yeah.
Before you have a child, you have to make you have to have a husband first.
Yeah. Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah, this is a learning point. This is a learning point. That's you have to build a good family, good marriage, because family is the last action of our attitude. Probably you are now single, you are living in boarding house, this is free for you to do many things. But when you are a wife of your husband, so we have any rules. Yeah, and a husband, you have to help your husband by having a good protection for you and your child.
And you too, you have to give some protection with your family, to your husband and to your son.
Do you have any opinion about the symbol, Bumina?
Yeah, to see about this picture, so I think that how we can create the happiness for our family, to give the love, to give other things or protection, attention to, especially for me, that how I can give my love to my husband, to my son, to my daughter, to all my family, to all my group in my family, and we can take protection each other, how we can give our love to our husband.
You said our husband. Please.
You are still single. I'm not single. I with my family. So
I have to protect my husband, and I have to protect my son, my children too.
Okay. Yeah.
That was great.
Thank you.
Okay, we move to the second question. After seeing the performance, I heard the chorus repeated several times in the song. Is there a permanent use of repetition or patterns in the song's lyric to emphasize a particular theme or message?
I just realized today with you, with the group and the crew here, when I discuss the song, there are many discussion about repetition for some song. And just I do realize, because the day before this, I know that Quran is stated many times with repetition. As I know that Quran is repeatedly stated because Allah said that it is to make you understand. So I repeat the Quran, but now I know that in the song we have refrain, Bumina, ref. In our common term, we have ref, ref is a refrain. In refrain, in the song, we have many repetition. And you said that this part is repeated four times, Bumina.
Yeah, four times.
And four times means how that this message is important. I promise anytime you call me, call is a Dexis, it refers to mom or your parents. If I'm not mistaken, we know that in Al-Quran, Surah Al-Isra, the verse of 23-24, Fala takul lahuma ufin. You cannot deny when your parents call you. Ufin in Arabic term is nanti dulu, nantar lah mah, ini lagi kabok. Don't say that. This is the command from Allah. That this is how Haris J rephrase, okay? And this is how the songwriter has the linguistic intelligence. That is Surat Al-Isra, but Haris J, I promise anytime you call me, it don't matter where I am. This is English, ladies and gentlemen. It doesn't use, it doesn't matter, but it don't, Bumina. It, but don't, not it doesn't. as English native, yeah, we have to accept.
Yeah.
This is not wrong. So why this is it? No, not it no, doesn't matter. Probably in our speaking, we know it doesn't matter whether.
Probably some people can ask about this condition. Why?
But you know, like in the Beatles, the use of it with don't, not doesn't. But native, we cannot say this is wrong. It don't matter where I am. So. Oh, you are, as the young generation, we have to imitate Haris J. I promise anytime you call me, it don't matter where I am, I always be there, like you have been there. You know, the use of tense here, you have been there. I always be there, like you have been there. You have been there, that as a parent, Bumina, we have to care for our children. If the children are sick, we are there. So this is the condition of the children. I'll always be there, like you have been there. The parents were there when you were sick, when you are in problems, when you are not in a good condition. So you have to be there because your parents have been there for you.
Always be there. Every time we get some satisfaction, or every time we can get a sadness in our life. I think our parents will accompany us. Wherever we are. We are. And to learn more about I promise. We have to make some promise to our parents. Because why? Because we are in the world. It's because of our parents.
And philosophically, ladies, philosophically, we are living here because of parents. That's why when the companion of Rasulullah asked to Rasul, Ya Rasulullah, what is the best attitude as an Islam? Birrul walidain.
Birrul
walidain. Because you will not be here. You will not be here. I am not here because parents. So that is why the base attitude is how to respect to our parents.
Oh, that's really beautiful, Dalfaya. Next question. Well, I found in the lyric that is one day when the table finally turned. Could you explain what table means in that part?
Yeah, table here. We will be talking about culture and table. You know, in English literature, in some universities, we have one course, and that course named table manner.
Table manner.
Because this is West culture. You know, like in the most films, like in Spider-Man, as I know, and in what films? In West culture, we have a breakfast or lunch or dinner in table. That is how family gathered. So when this is called by table, when you were as children, you are sitting in the table, we breakfast together, we lunch together, we dinner together. And then so when you are married with your children, you will care for your parents with the same table. That's why in West culture, table is very important, because the table is how and when family together having breakfast or lunch or dinner.
Everything.
And I don't know about our East culture, Bumirna, you are ladies. Do you have any culture that you with your family breakfast together or lunch together
on the table?
Yeah, dinner together with
together
the family.
Together with the family, on the table, of course.
On the table.
Let's to get our breakfast on the early morning. Come on.
But you know, in some of our cultures, in East culture, we have lesehan. So table here would be referred to the West culture, and the main thing of the theme is how your members of your family together having breakfast or lunch or dinner in the table.
Not every for the lunch or dinner, I think every condition.
Every condition.
We can together in a family. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can together in a family and to discuss about the table. It's like how Allah give a gift for us. Mm. Yeah, a gift for us. Yeah, and the son or the children is a child is great gift. Yeah, from Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala.
That's right. Yeah.
Well, and I also heard the lyrics, and your feelings hit a wall. Hmm. What kind of figurative language was conveyed in that part?
Yeah, this is one of the figurative language hit a wall. Feelings hit a wall means in the figurative language we know personification. Personification, because hit refers to the one that is animate in semantic. Mm-hmm. Feeling cannot hit, because hit is done by us like human or animal hit. But this is figurative language, because and your feeling hit a wall. The place before that clause is there are days when I just don't want to talk. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is our adab, humanities. This is adab, our adab, is our ethic, Bumina. When your parents are angry, you have to be quiet. This is our adab.
Yeah.
You cannot deny.
Say anything.
Yeah, you don't have to say anything. Yeah, please let your parents angry and you have to be quiet. That is our adab, our ethic.
Yeah.
There are days when I just don't want to talk.
Yeah, you just be quiet, right?
Yeah, and your feeling hit a wall means that is how your parents give advice for you.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be quiet. Whether you are right, just be quiet. Yeah. That is the adab, that is the ethic.
Yeah, the best advice is it can be seen from our parents. Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. So yeah, I agree with your opinion. Yeah, we have to be quiet. Yeah. If not, our parents give some advice to us.
Mm.
Okay. Well, the next this is question is still related to the lyrics. Well, the section that was seen from above. What does the word above refers to, and approximately what is the urgency of that diction?
Okay, yeah, above. Yeah, above means it could be sky. Mm. It could be from Allah.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, ladies and gentlemen, probably.
Yeah, probably.
Ladies and gentlemen.
You don't follow gentlemen in our discussion.
You are in the sixth semester, Bumirna, me. We can choose our couple.
Mm.
We can choose our girl for me. You can choose your man. But for parents, we cannot choose whose parent we are.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. If you want to be in Indonesia or in England, America, Australia, you cannot choose. But parent is a gift.
Gift yeah, from Allah.
From Allah. That is sent from
sent
above.
From above.
Yeah. You know, Abu Mina, there is Rasulullah says that in the riwayah, you will be born to this earth and you don't know anything about how to live here, but Rasulullah says that Allah will send you an angel to guide you on this earth, to guide you to live well. Who is that angel? That is your mother. That is your mother.
So I have heard one hadith like Ridallah wa Ridul Walidain, Wasallallahu Sofatul Walidain.
That's right.
So the good decision it can take from our parents. Yeah, how we can create our life good to our parents. It can mean seen that how we can take some good communication with our parents.
Because your parents is your gift.
Mm.
This is a sign from above. Please respect your parents, your mom. And this is one of your successfulness lies in the prayer of your parents, of your mom.
Yeah, we have to say Alhamdulillah. Yeah, because why? Because we have a good family in our life. We have a good environment, yeah, to create our best future, yeah. Yeah, so we have to thanks to Allah, Alhamdulillah.
Yeah, Alhamdulillah. We have good parents. Alhamdulillah. Okay, we're getting to the last question.
Last question. Mm.
What message do you think iFirmis can face to its listeners? Yeah.
Me first.
Yeah, so minimally, yeah, in every day we have to pray to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala in every time, yeah, five times, yeah, in every day after we have taken our salat, yeah, Robbighfirli dzunubi wali walidayya warhamhuma kama rabbayani shaghira. It's my conclusion. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Because essentially. You are here. You are here because of our parents. We have to respect our parents. That is, you have to promise whether in what condition you are, who you are, wherever you are. Mm-hmm. Please respect your parents and promise your parents that you will be there when your parents call you.
Every time. Everywhere.
Yeah. So, everyone. We really need to maintain our relationship with fellow humans as our religion has taught us in the terms of Hablum Minannas. We should maintain our relationship with family, neighbors, friends, and especially parents. As in the song I Promise, that dedicated to parents as the one who most deserves our love.
Yeah, and also, don't forget to cultivate love for our Muslim brothers and sisters, especially those who are currently undergoing trials that violate their human rights. Our brothers and sisters in Palestine, let's support each other and pray for the best for them and this ummah.
Amen.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Yudi and Ms. Nuna,
anytime,
for the very detailed and interesting explanation. So, See you next time, and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Yeah, how we can give our love to our husband? Okay, tarik nafas dulu dalam-dalam. Udah siap?
Mundur.